Hi, hello, and welcome to my channel, Leaning to Six Sigma. So, in this vlog, what I'm going to talk about is the Four Eyes Principle. And leading to cost of poor quality. Very interesting in terms of what this concept is all about. Let me cover it in my next slide. I'm going to cover in Four Eyes Principle. In fact, when I say Four Eyes, Maker Checker. So Maker Checker is an age-old concept, in fact. So somebody creates it, somebody is checking it. The whole point, what I'm going to discuss here, why this particular blog is, Maker Checker concept will not ensure or prevent process quality, defect-free. It will not. It will definitely create defect. Even one defect will wipe out the company. That's the whole point. That's a 4i principle. Let's look at it in my next slide. As I mentioned, this is an age-old banking concept. In the banking concept, anybody would say this. Maker checker means somebody creating it, somebody is checking it, somebody is approving it. So this is how the maker checker works. The whole idea of checker process exists primarily to fix the errors created by the maker. So this is the understanding of process quality, and unfortunately, which is still being widely practiced because there must be a checker. That's the whole idea. People have not moved to the first time right. So how to create first time right even now is a challenge for many, many processes, in fact. So one of them is the banking sector. Though this concept came from banking sector and a lot of automations, etc., but still they have the maker checker concept. But why I picked up this is an age old one. The primary reason is why I picked up this principle, because the latest goof up by Citibank, transfer of $900 million erroneously to the lenders instead of $8 million. So this is the biggest blunder in the history of banking transaction, isn't it? Paid wrongly to the, by mistake to the lenders. So the maker checker concept, which I mentioned in my previous slide, will not ensure process quality. This is the reason. So exactly they did the same thing, and they created, there is a maker, there is a checker, and there is an approver. Still nobody found out that they were working on the erroneous transaction. That's the whole point. And this is the example, the latest erroneous transfer. So I'm not getting into this case and who did it and why they did it, etc. That's not part of my scope here. The whole idea is there's a maker who keyed in the transaction, the checker who checked what maker has entered based on the same criteria or whatever, and the approver approved it and transferred 900 million. So the whole idea from a quality professional, when I got this news, it's exactly struck me. Maker checker will not ensure process quality. This we have been saying for many, many years, and trying to move away from this and then create a process which itself doesn't produce any defect. So why we say this? Primarily because having a checker, one checker, somebody can argue, right? So why only one checker? Let's have another checker. Let's have another checker. Where's the end to it? So which means a process which produces an error, passes on this to the next process, thinking that next process will ensure, is the primary basic level one quality of a process. This is not a level five quality of a process. So one transaction will wipe out the company. The case example, maker checker concept, because I'm not going to deal with Citibank case here, but this triggered me maker checker, fraudulent angle. There are two angle I'm going to deal with this. The maker checker concept in a more financial industry, this is valid. The fraudulent angle, somebody can collude with each other and then create a fraudulent transaction. If you rely on the maker checker, that's the whole point here. So maker checker can collude, educated fraudler, fraudster can join to find an opportune time, because you are creating that opportunity in the process design, and resource reporting to the manager who is under pressure. Because if I am reporting to a manager whose intention is to create a fraudulent transactions, then I need to do it because I'm under pressure. And limitless transaction for maker and checker. Limitless means you can approve any amount, you can create any amount, which is exactly what happened in the Citibank case. So limitless approval rights should not be given. There must be multiple metrics should be there, at least if not having a robust check. So multiple approvals, instead multiple approvals, you need to have multiple scenarios and then you differentiate the level of approval probably will reduce, it will not eliminate again. So this is a fraudulent angle. And of course, if a new employee is joining, obviously he will be under pressure to say okay and then do the transaction the way the reporting manager asked to do. So this is fraudulent angle. Here I am dealing with the effectiveness angle. Effectiveness angle means, okay, I'm not committing any mistake, but I don't know whether I'm working on an erroneous transaction or not, which I don't know because the process design is such. So we have to move away from MC, maker checker concept, to do it first time right, FTR. Unless my process maturity, every transaction or every year I move away from the maker checker, I don't think so this will prevent, because this is exactly against the FTR, first time right quality, or the level 5 process maturity what a quality professional is talking about. And this leads to cost of poor quality. From where this cost of poor quality comes from, because especially in the transactional industry, many service industry, people used to wonder where this cost is incurred, because it's not reported in the financial accounts. But when we step in and then say, hey, because of cost of poor quality, because of your poor process quality, this company loses $1 million every month, for example. If we say that, people used to wonder from where you are picking up these numbers, because they are not able to relate a particular transaction or the poor quality process leading to the money impact to the company. So this is one such example. So if you are not doing it first time right, if your process doesn't produce defect free 100%, not even 99.999967, 100%, if it is not defect free, I don't think so we are moving towards the process quality at all. So Citibank is one such example. Just to summarize this, 2, 4, 6 eyes, because I have seen in many companies, it's not just two people, maker and checker, maker, checker and checker, because first checking level is not enough. Let me have another checker. So MC square, E equal to MC square, Albert Einstein talked about it. But here the MC square is maker, checker and checker will not prevent process quality from making mistake at all. Some suggestions I am giving here, I'm not taking it at length here, but few suggestions here. Create a process which produces first time right. That's the level we have to move. Second, bring in automation controls. So okay, you don't have an option to have without a checker. So bring in automated controls, automation controls. Now we are talking about robotic process automation. Bring in automation, probably the way out. Eliminate unlimited sanctioning powers for a maker checker. This will prevent financial fraudulence and erroneous transaction. Mistake proof, we heard about it. Error proof, we talked about it. Fool proof, we talked about it. And now the fraudulent proof, because somebody can do some mistake. I'm not referring Citibank here. The whole point is, if fraud to happen, the process design offers, there's a potential. That's the whole point. Finally, change in the thinking pattern. Unless you change the culture and attitude, the thinking pattern, because many service industry, especially which I encountered, people always say, no, there must be a checker. Even a report, the people have to check it. The next person has to check it before it goes to CEO or to the reporting manager. So the entire culture, the thinking pattern is, there must be a checker to ensure defect free. This attitude, this culture has to change. If you don't change the culture, I don't think so we will move. Others are technicalities, a process design, bringing automation, what will make it happen, etc. It's a technical aspects of the process change. But thinking pattern is not changed. It's not reversed. When I make it, I'll make it first time right. I don't think so this will ever happen in the service industry or transaction industry. Even one transaction will wipe out the entire company's name, image, and financially it will burden the company. Citi is one such example. That's all from my end. I'll meet you with my next blog of very interesting topic, which will benefit to you. And in case if you have any suggestions, if you have any topic to suggest, anything for that matter, please do drop in your comments. Please subscribe to my channel, Leaning Towards Six Sigma. I have a lot of case studies, experience I have shared. Please do encourage for many such videos. Thank you so much. See you in my next vlog.